This is my small Phalaenopsis orchid. This is what I got. I picked up at a grocery store, and this is its second time blooming, which is really kind of cool. I mean, I'm not much of an orchid lover, and I know some orchid lovers out there are going to be like, what? How can you not be an orchid lover? But I just picked this Phalaenopsis up in particular at the supermarket because I really loved the coloration of these particular flowers. And you could see Phalaenopsis orchids in all sorts of different kinds of colors. Now, I'm not always great at reblooming my Phalaenopsis orchids, and I was shocked that actually this one kind of bloomed because I wasn't taking as good of care of it as I should have been. But I think that goes to a testament to why that might be the case. Phalaenopsis orchids are more epiphytic, so you can actually see some of the roots if I could pull out, and you can actually see some of the roots here. This one's starting to shrivel up a little bit, and I probably need to actually water this, but the way that I water the Phalaenopsis orchid is that you dunk it in water that has been sitting out. I don't like to usually dunk it in fresh water unless it's like filtered water, and kind of a warmish, you know, water, nothing too cold, and you could dunk it for every 2 weeks, more or less. That's how I do it. Dunk it in, let it sit in the water for about an hour, and then kind of pull it out. Because you're trying to recreate a little bit more of the rain that you might get in an outdoor environment for Phalaenopsis orchids. The other thing that I think is really key for this is when you're kind of going through winter, you want to give this a little bit more of a cooler period during that dormant season. So what's a challenge, you know, especially within our homes, is that our homes are always at this kind of constant temperature unless you kind of turn the heat down at night. And I think what part of the reason why this one rebloomed for me is I had this in my bathroom near a window that could get a little bit draftier, and it was like towards on the ground. So it was not necessarily in any kind of heated environment. My bathroom does have a tendency to get a little bit cooler during the winter period. So I think that really helped, and you could actually see there's another third little bloom that is about to bloom on this Phalaenopsis orchid. Orchids will actually take on some fertilizing. You could do it on, you know, bi-weekly to monthly basis, if you will, and you could go with something that's a little bit lighter, maybe like a 7-5-6. You will see that there are some pretty sizable leaves, and although this plant is maybe known for its blooms, having the leaves that are strong and being able to take in some more of that sunlight is going to be super important. But otherwise, Phalaenopsis is probably one of the more common orchids to be able to get in your home. I always see people buying them when they go in the supermarket, and it's hard not to because they do have such pretty blooms. So that's basically my tips for this plant. Never had any pest problems with it whatsoever, and really makes a beautiful plant that keeps its blooms for weeks on end.